Greetings, DDO stream viewers. I am Gemini166, and it is time for DDO as she is played. The new time that I have because work-related reasons. So I have just joined an LFM advertising Tempest Spine, which seemed like a joke because I admittedly there weren't any tempting LFMs to get my main on. So Tempest Spine was a good, nice second place. Greetings, Titan! Greetings from the United States, Amy Lee, 4000. More specifically, since I just, as an American, I assume that everybody knows the American states, Northern Alabama specifically. Insert your incest jokes now. I'm interested in battle and glory.
Drawn by the molten lava, blazing fire elementals patrol the caldera.
You know? I don't think I've ever seen anybody go that way, so I'm going to see what they're up to, get it, because they're going on a higher path than I would have. Come on now, Seymour. Let's try to keep it in good taste. Let's be civil here. We don't need to give you a timeout now. I'll have you know, I only thought one of my cousins was hot ever. Mouse and keyboard. My mouse has extra buttons on it, so my entire second row right here, I activate from my mouse. It more than doubles my active skill range since I can only hit like 1 through 4 comfortably on my keyboard. Look at me, entirely prepared for this quest. Complete with potions and everything. Yes, it was actually a Christmas gift from my brother. Why am I hitting all the wrong buttons? Where's my disable device item? I hope I'm wearing it. There it is. I'm gonna switch these around. There we go.
Junction, you spy a massive metal gateway. Right, little turn. warlock approaching the crystal box has triggered some mechanism within the iron golem.
Look at me not carrying adamantine.
Final signal crystal ignites, revealing a portal into an unknown area of the mountain.
Let's cast a couple of cure light wounds. There we go.
Lair of fire and ice.
I'm pretty sure the ice people will cast like no save spells, so I always go to fire side if I have evasion. Somebody's probably already killed it though. Nope. Let's just do it. Just do it. Oh lord, there's a bunch of enemies here.
Ice will reform as fire still burns.
Somebody heal me.
Entering the treasure room, you spy chests.
Ice is down. Excellent. I hope I get the goggles of perception. I want those. So, Titan, have you considered running in Shiradi Champion and just twisting the light spell power from Exalted Angel? Huh? Huh? Truth be told, Titan. No, wait. It's not on this person. However, I'm lawful, so Maelstrom would give me a negative level.
More drow, under the effects of Sorjak's crown. Guard a sealed stone door that blocks further passage into the mountain. A deep hole offers no sign of egress, although a soft, cool breeze can be felt coming from below. Peering over the edge, you realize that a fall from this height would be devastating, if not deadly. Curses and spits blood at your feet as she collapses in a heap. Peering over the edge, you realize that a fall from this height would be devastating, if not deadly.
Oh, and actually, you're using Utter Dark Blast, too. You were on that, what's it called? Piercing Blast? For a minute. Air quotes, other important. Oh no, Nadja! There, live, Nadja! Now it summons fire elementals! Let's kill them, just to be kind. When I say it out loud, I realize that piercing spellcraft is kind of an uninspired name. But, you know, whatevs. We don't need to be creative all the time. I was like, is it piercing blast? That doesn't sound like the kind of creativity they usually go for in their enhancement names. Oh, dang it, you would hit me with some sweet healing. I'm almost certain that would be impulse spell power, Seymour, same as the standard blast. Penetrating that, there we go. That's a bit more inspired than piercing blast. Penetrating, yes. Nobody's touched this rune, probably because it's trapped. However, Seymour, your Eldritch Blasts, while under the effect of Penetrating Blast, deal piercing damage instead of the usual, force damage. And they also, has plus 1d6... packed dice.
Stone pillars poke through the surface of the water ahead. This may be a good spot to regain your strength and breath. A scent of sour, rotting flesh permeates the air here. Another beast summoned by Sorjak lies in wait nearby.
It took me a second, Seymour, to realize that by SP you meant spell power and not spell points. I was like, what? What do you mean, where is he getting his spell points? Does he have an impressive amount of spell points on his warlock? Actually might be a little bit sad if I loot the goggles of perception, because I'm pretty sure like all the gear in here binds on acquire, which makes me sad, by the way. But yes, Titan, I think I've mentioned already, but I do plan on going back through this portal, because I think I missed some loot.
The flooded tunnel.
No, I didn't. Maybe I did, but I'm not worried about it anymore.
The flooded tunnel.
Anyhow, as I have probably already mentioned, I do plan on taking my current main and getting some epic past lives under my belt. See how powerful that makes me for my heroic lives. I am really bad at searching. I knew this already, but it's still surprising every time.
Hill giants ensure that the drow encamped ahead are only resting from their labors, a pitiful state for a once free people. looks recently used as the dust of its base.
Nope. Not messing with rest monsters. Please don't mess with me, rest monsters.
Sudden breeze swirls the dust in the chamber.
Speaking of views, I am proud to have access to the DDO stream dashboard now. However, a couple noteworthy things. On my dashboard, I do not have the stream delay slider nor the commercial break button. And then also, I was sad because I couldn't look at DDO stream the channel's stats, because I was curious about whether I got more viewers on my DDO stream channel days than my other days. I know y'all all do, but I just got my access today. So, there's that.
Sealed doors along the tunnel appear immovable. An uneasy feeling overcomes you as you continue forward.
Pretty sure I have an exalted smite right now. Yes, why am I even using my regular smite still?
A wicked sensation washes over you as you enter the junction. To the left, the path turns sharply out of sight. To the right, the tunnel inclines slightly.
Looks like we're doing Vaughn next, and I might just change characters for that, get that on my main, because main. It seems that Titan has finally seen the light, regarding light-based Eldritch Blasts. Greetings, Vornami! You may not be a morning lord, but that doesn't mean you can't benefit from, like, the light spell power from Enlightened Spirit. Greetings, Storm Dweller 007. That is unfortunate, because this is a great game, and to be deprived of playing it is, yes, saddening. I would be sad if I couldn't log in. And Tier 2 Thunderforged. I have never crafted, not even a green steel, so, like, Thunderforged is just up there, like, beyond the scope of what I even consider getting for any of my characters. Probably because I don't run epics much in general. Oh, what a convenient thaumaturgy staff. I love... There's nothing quite like the feeling of getting precisely the thaumaturgy staff you want. Like, on my wizard, I was a conjuration archmage wizard, which means that my conjuration spells were mostly, like, acid. So I would, of course, look for acid spell power, and I'm pretty sure one time I found a thaumaturgy of acid and fire with acid lore, and that was pretty nice. It's like, great, because fire is another thing that has a couple combustion things in it. Whoa, uh-oh, I just got tossed. Let's totally not cheat.
Swordjack and Connie crumbles to the ground, defeated.
Whoa, my Featherfall got, like, removed from me? I guess it was a spell. You didn't see that. I'm not abusing the stuck command. Especially not on the official DDO stream channel. Oh snap, the elemental mithril breastplate! I feel like it was worth that. That's pretty nice. Everybody loves the elemental mithril breastplate. I don't have, like, an especially huge appreciation of it, but... yeah. Also, greetings, Lyrical! It's good to see you. Unfortunately, I know Titan said that I was gonna be there the other day. I wasn't. I actually left my room, which is already a big enough surprise just by itself, and then I was conversing with my housemates, which is, again, another level of... just don't even believe this story. I'm actually interacting with people. Oh, nice, a ring. Be nice. And then when I got done conversing with my housemates, I went to bed. So, there's that. Okay, I'm going to do something probably bad and toss my planar gird into the shared bank for my other guy to get, my main character, because I want heroism on demand, please, on the character that I consider to be my main primary character. I really hope I'm flagged. I'm almost certain I ran all four of the flagging quests. My rogue monk, fighter, sneak attack, punching, speed demon. Which is actually probably more fun than I thought it would be, especially in a party when I will, like, not have aggro. It's quite nice to get all the sneak attack damage. What is my current disabling item? 7? I guess it is time to switch to my lucky boots. Oh wait, does this mean it's time to switch to the lucky hat as well? Apparently not, because it is not on my person. Oh well. Oh, there it is. Necklace. So I've already got it on my bar there. Let's slap Baphomet's LFM. There. I forgot the command for whispering there for a good minute. Okay, does anybody know the search DCs of Elite Vault Von 5? I'm looking them up right now. This isn't... Ugh. Oh well. Greetings, Gary782. I'm gonna change enhancements because I really do not want to freaking goof up and blow a trap in here. I'm missing something. Oh, I had that earlier, but I don't care about it right now. Turn in that quest, and then I'll be flagged. Let's get my enhancements on my bars. Okay.
You emerge into the vault's central shaft, already secured by the laughing knives. The master thieves stand ready to offer you their assistance. Dirge of Karnath grins, fully at ease in his heavy plate. The glyph on the Drow Vampirus Vale stands here, taut and ready for action. The glyph on the portal reads, accounting.
Okay. So I'm gonna go ahead and pop my... There we go. Save! Excellent!
You hear a low thrumming roar as the distribution grid returns to service. Seems clanking and ratcheting noises echo along this long corridor. The machinery below must still be active. The corridor is divided by a force wall and lined with deadly looking tracks on both sides. A complex set of controls waits at the end of the gauntlet.
Oh. I rolled a 1. Oh! Another one! WTF! Come on, freaking random number god. I have all the luck. All of it. It's mine. If I roll another one, I am gonna lose it. Okay. So when I actually don't roll a 1,
sizzle, filling the hall with acrid ozone.
Okay, I rolled another one that time. That was another one, but at least I had another couple of saves before it. Success on a one. Excellent. Okay. So I was a little bit, when I tried to join the group, he's like, can you do the traps? I'm like, I think so. And my main issue with doing the traps has been my horrendous luck. I'm sure those two failed saves made him nervous. He might not have believed that I had actually rolled two ones in a row. Maybe I could have alternated sides and had less saves to make, but that would have also been really annoying. I hate... running back and forth. Okay, so I guess I should put on my feather fall and... I feel a little bit less bad about rolling ones when I have it on film that the only reason I failed that save is because I rolled a one. I guess I should unlock this chest, maybe. There we go. Chest unlocked. I wonder why party leader dude said two left and everybody else right. Seems like the other way makes more sense, because if somebody falls, they're gonna end up on the right anyways. I wonder if he plans on doing Vaughn 6. If this is locked, is it like... It's not a pickable lock, it's a triggered lock. It's a remote lock.
I'll go get to the coffer.
I feel feel like I'm waiting for something, but I don't know for sure what, I guess. It's a pretty fancy looking heavy pick and Kopesh.
A subsonic hum cuts off abruptly. The north portal conduit
blazes
with channeled energy.
We ready.
Later, two loud crackling noises echo throughout the vault.
Greetings, RC Gardeners.
The free flow of power through the north portal conduit has been restored.
I feel like maybe there's a trap somewhere that I could disable. I've already disabled this one. I can feel the safety. Why am I not sneaking? I should be running at full speed. Yeah, I don't think I slowed down here.
It seems impossible that only a third of the gates are operating generally here.
Ah? Well, that's the secret, RC Gunnez. It's actually a rogue. It's like a sneak attack spamming build. Because Monk Unarmed is apparently the fastest attack speed in the game. So, spam. Sneak attack as fast as I can is the goal here. You can see I got in like 6 sneak attacks during my little dinky 1 second, or it's probably, oh, it's 2.5 seconds now. I got several sneak attacks in during that like 2.5 second window of my shiv. Get over here, Sentinel. Blind. I've got my blindness to render vulnerable to sneak attack. I've got stunning fist when it works to render vulnerable to sneak attack, and I've got shiv. Oh, I should probably disable these various traps in here. That would be the cool guy thing to do, I believe. I gimped a monk, and it was still okay, I guess? So I'm trying to not, you know, gimp a thing. It seems like it would be nice. Terminal Delirium is crazy. It's so difficult. I think it would be a bit less difficult if I actually joined a run with a good rogue, but like, navigating everything as a balloon, and that mirror room is just a nightmare.
The east portal conduit blazes with channeled energy.
The dance-off is very amusing.
Fortunately, the Rust Emperor
that part was actually, we had a bard in the party, so like, he kept them fascinated, and that part was a breeze.
This bridge is strongly reinforced, as if built to bear the weight of mountains. Another impressive span arches above you. Mistress Orkney looks exhausted, but she manages a shy smile of welcome. The glyph on this portal, a unique system of force lifts, has been rigged in this shaft. The equipment vibrates with harnessed power.
I will trust in Bafama's reflex saves. I am not hopping on there, it's dangerous. Be glad to disable the traps, but yeah, not touching flame jets. Ow! Oh, I didn't die that time. Oh, somebody else got it. Looks like I'm not the only trapper here. Excellent. I have outlived my usefulness. Turn on my ocean stance again. I turned on fire stance earlier to get a tiny little boost to my jump skill. I forgot to go back to ocean. I could have been increasing my saves this whole time. Alright, I'm gonna punch a dragon. That sounds like a good time. I'm gonna punch a dragon. Anybody want to place their bets on whether I have enough reflex saves to evade the dragon breath? Uella's got the skills. Delicious boots. I need some of these quests. Noice. Let me just grab level 10 right quick and head back in. I'm gonna punch a dragon. I'm pretty excited about this, actually. Punching a dragon. That is unfortunate. Lyrical. need to stay connected. My, actually, like yesterday, my Firefox kept crashing. It crashed like 2 or 3 times just while I was trying to like stream. Luckily, it crashed all 3 times before anyone actually typed anything in the chat, but still, I was pretty upset. Okay, so I'm on base 1. Thin winds swirl around you as you step into the core. Okay, there's fire, so I can evade there. That sounds good to me. The dragon screams. I will never escape this place alive. My sacrifice will not be in vain. This thing isn't pretty very,
One of the vault's pillars crackles with
disrupted energy.
One of the vault's pillars, the last pillar, has been wrecked. The wall of force protecting the dragon blinks out of existence.
Oh, does that mean I should be extra loud so that your coworkers hear you? The dragon screams. Ignorant children. Ow.
Do you think I sold my freedom for mere greed?
Alright, give me my songs. I'm going to punch this dragon. Hopefully with sneak attack damage. Cause if I don't get sneak attack damage, I ain't gonna live very long. Yeah. Oh yes, delicious sneak attack damage. She's going down fast. Oh, the healers did. That was pretty. Yes. That was a pretty good run, actually. Von 5 and 6. Come on, loot, loot, loot. Ah, no loot here. Oh, I forgot to chant. Healing of Kyber! Healing of Kyber! Healing of Kyber! Ah, no. Oh, the Disciplinator. It's alright. A slow-moving ball of electricity? I asked Helena of Kyber for some of her loot luck one time, and she said that I should chant her name 3 times. Ah. And it hasn't worked yet. But yeah. That's pretty good. I like that. Well, I hope somebody was very happy to get that Sword of Shadows shard. Well, you already have an epic Sword of Shadows, though, don't you? So you don't even need it. You done got it already. Now you're just being greedy.
Thanks.
so let's see. I just ran the Dinieth chain recently, and I'm actually ready to take level 10. I don't think I need another Tempest Spine. I'll just take my level and go from there. It's my base attack bonus, only plus 6. Yeah, I'll take a couple more rogue levels. Not really necessary, but I like to have it. More sneak attack damage, oh yes. Okay, so. Prison of the Plains. Oh yeah, I forgot I have low level person. They're already IP on. This is why I don't like being so dependent on LFMs. Wizard King Elite. Yeah, let's join Pip Troll. So back to my Paladin. Remember to turn on my stances this time. I'm a little bit sad without my planar gird, but I'll just have to deal with that. I brought this upon myself. Why do I have the feather falling ring on there twice? I'll tell you why, because I'm stupid.
This impressive structure houses
oh, dang,
the tomb
I forgot
of
to...
the Wizard King.
I've still got about half durability. It should be fine. Are up here.
An imposing Shino snarls at your
approach. Also, greetings, Croiserer. I feel like I might have forgotten to greet you.
Hurry. For the Wizard King awaits.
Yes, I thought you did, but I don't think I greeted you at that time, which is poor manners on my part.
Calls out to you. Welcome, traveler. You will learn to call this place home as I have.
Lamania is up? Oh, does that mean that there's notable changes happening in this, update? I have admittedly not been, keeping up so much with it. This way's 28. Was it the Epic Veil? For some reason, I was pretty sure that the box was on top of a sarcophagus here. Apparently, I was wrong. Either that, or I just plain can't find it. What's my search item? Oh, my snakeskin vest, which I think is still a relevant item at this level, so it's my own fault that I can't find this stuff. Slay Living hit me for 105 points of negative damage. Oh well. Greetings, Skunk City! As you can see, I died. And he did, in fact, pull the lever to open this. Good guy. Is it this one that the box is on top of the sarcophagus? Come on now, self. Come on now, skeletons. They trolling me. Oh my god. My skill boost is gonna wear off before I even can search for the box. happen to have, like, an intelligence item, do I? Oh, I do. This could be useful. There it is. To one on Slay Living. Excellent. Oh Lord, I forgot about this. I can't get onto the... Screw this. I somehow did not have to... The shuriken? Ow! This is just a Shadow Star. I'm not even proficient in it. And also, I have TR'd the character that used those. Yeah, into my current sneak attack puncher. I punched a dragon! That's pretty nice. Me in the back, why don't you, skeletons? That is the best thing you could do right now. I need to just... Yeah, I thought you had seen it. What do you mean by, can you see the shurikens, though? If not the, those. Those skeletons. Obviously, I'm the one they want to fight.
genie blocks your path.
I am bound to draw this gate portal.
This place, lovely. I feel like I'm lagging a bit. The shurikens from tab 4. Okay. If you saw it, that's fine. Okay. Yeah, it's just a shadow store.
You stand before Rayum, wizard.
Dang it! I didn't want to fight Rayum first.
His majesty.
And he's got a cold fire shield too.
The wizard team collapses into a moldering heap of ragged cloth and dust.
Does the tower that Ryan is in change from playthrough to playthrough of the quest? Because I get the impression that it does. Yep, they're located randomly.
This impressive structure houses the tomb of the Wizard King.
stuff. Oh, a cloak of invisibility. I should consider wearing that. Oh, I already have another elemental mithril breastplate. How embarrassing. I was so excited to get that other one. Two ain't gonna do me any good because they're bound to character. My daily dice and weekly dice. Oh, consolation prize. Not bad. Remember what level my fighter is. Did I ever get to level 6? Yes, in fact I did. That is important information. Oh, he's doing Relic of the Sovereign Past. I figure I can try Relic of the Sovereign Past with him. Oh yeah, but the quest giver's in House D. Man, I'm not running all the way to House D. None of that. I would be the guy who neglects to get my search skill up. No wonder I can't find anything.
This small pool of lava seems to cause the walls in here to sweat profusely.
I'm 89% fortification. Okay.
Appears to serve as a checkpoint. Dwarven guards pass both sides of this gate.
Greetings, Elatrix _.
Rumbling voices of dwarves can be heard behind the doors here. This must be the barracks.
named Wurgar are considered evil, kind of similarly to Hal. I'm just gonna smite and see what kind of damage it does. Yeah, that looked like a crit smite. I am on Arganesson. Until recently, I was running on my rogue, or actually I've been switching back and forth between my rogue and this one. Started on this one, swapped to rogue, back to this one. I wonder why Vella is like the only red dragon in Eberron. All the other ones are black and white and blue. And you got freaking Vella, the one red dragon. Are there? 'Cause, let's see. I feel like the other red ones are in the Forgotten Realms. Okay, there are some in the Giant Hold Slayer area. Greetings, Nyarlathotep! Okay. Well, I haven't been in Epics much, so that would explain why I didn't see that. Still, like, you go into Giant Hold, and in the tour, there's the black and white and blue one. And then, there's the black one in what's the black dragon? What is this locked? I forgot the name of the quest. The Necro for Litany of the Dead. Yeah, that's it. And then there's the black one mired in kobolds. And then there's the white one in... I forget the name of the quest, but it's in the Reaver's Reach chain. No, not enter the kobold. It's, oh, yeesh, it's got all them frost giants that want to kill Osirkaics, is it, that they want to kill? Or is it just some other white dragon? Prey on the hunter, that sounds right. I thought it had the word hunter in there.
Burning incense fills this passage.
And also, I feel like... Is the truthful one a red? He didn't look like a red. I would have guessed blue. I mean, I'm just saying, judging by faithful facial structure, everything, because, you know, the black ones have, like, the horns, and then the blue ones and white ones admittedly look the same, and then Vela's the only red one I've seen. It's got that doofy face. I guess she's got that doofy face. I guess Vela's supposed to be a woman. Another pure fighter. Anyways, I don't know who Will Graham is or what he did to make Vela not a red dragon.
Beyond appears to be a temple hewn from the earth itself. A large, moon-covered altar at the center. Durgar High Priest begins an incantation of summoning.
I mean, let's get real here, though, Nyarla at the Hotep. The truthful one is a lich. So, I mean, he's gonna have enough knowledge of the arcane to breathe whatever he wants, I think. Seymour, I doubt that a Dracolich would want to breathe rainbows and puppies, but I'm not going to be the one to tell it that it cannot breathe rainbows and puppies. Or weak old socks, just whatever. A Dracolich can breathe whatever he wants. I see you attempted to earth grab me. Now you're not evil, why did I even waste a smite on you?
Statues of crowned dwarves line the wall within this room.
How come we don't get the enlarged person spells? But these Durgar can cast it. Not only that, but they get bigger when they cast it too. When we cast enlarge animal on ourselves, do we get bigger? No. I'm no good at the whole, searching business, apparently. I'm gonna pop a heroism potion and see how that works. Not well enough. That one did spew fumes. Still fail on a one, of course. Is that ingenious? Yep. Excellent. Even though I blew one up. Is this the last door? Yes.
A final pair of blackguards stand at attention before this set of gates. The king's chambers lie on the other side of the wall.
Okay, I think after this quest, I'm gonna call it a night. That night was a pretty good night. Punched a dragon. think we're waiting on Budweiser, who just joined the party, to enter the quest.
A sword hangs suspended beneath a magical dome at the center of this room. But the hard gaze of the man standing behind it draws your attention.
It doesn't even have an improved critical profile. It would have been nice if you had shared before we completed the quest, but I mean, I'm actually curious to see if this works. Loot though? Where's he going? Oh no, wait, we're not finished because we haven't grabbed this sword, Theseus. So excellent. I'm still curious, though, whether if you're shared a quest after it's completed while you're standing in there, if it'll let you turn it in, or if you have to actually have it before the quest, because I think you'd have to have it before the quest was completed. I'm not running all the way to House D to turn it in, though, either, so, yeah. Alrighty then, so I'm going to end the stream there for tonight. Thank you for watching. It's a pleasure hanging out with you. take care and good night.